Hello everyone, everything good? Welcome to my channel. It's a pleasure to welcome you here. My name is Isaac, and today, guys, I brought you a video about air conditioning temperature sensors. Let's watch the video. Guys, in most air conditioners, there are two types of sensors, the NTC sensor and the PTC sensor. What does this mean? NTC stands for negative temperature coefficient, and PTC stands for positive temperature coefficient. What is the difference between the two? PTC works as follows. As the temperature increases, the resistance value also increases. In the case of NTC, it is the opposite. As the temperature increases, the resistance of the component decreases. This is the basic difference. What is the application for the NTC sensor? It is generally used in the room temperature sensor and in the defrost temperature sensor. In the compressor, where there is compressor discharge temperature and hot gas, the PTC is generally used. This is because as the temperature increases, the resistance also increases, which reduces the flow of current, protecting the board and the electronic circuit. Remember, everyone, that every time you open a piece of equipment, you need to have the electrical manual and know exactly which temperature sensors are in the equipment and which of them are NTC and PTC. To perform the diagnosis and maintenance correctly, you need to know which sensors are in the equipment according to the manual you are reading, which can vary from one brand to another. Once you have defined which sensors and their types, you can proceed with the sensor testing procedure. Let's do a practical test using a 10K NTC temperature sensor. Remember that the NTC has a negative temperature coefficient, which means that as the temperature increases, the resistance decreases, and if the temperature decreases, the resistance increases. We have a table that relates resistance and temperature. You can find this table both in the equipment manual and with the component manufacturer, which provides this technical information as a reference. I place the two test leads on the sensor. Remember that to measure resistance, there's no need to worry about polarity. I set the multimeter to the 20 kilo-ohm scale, but you can choose a scale close to the value you are going to read. For example, if you are going to take a reading of 10K, you can set it to 20 to 100K, a little above the value you are reading. This depends a lot on the equipment you have. In my case, I set it to the 20 kilo scale to take a reading of a 10 kilo component. On the multimeter, the value read from this sensor is around 10.9 to 11K. Why is this happening? Because the temperature is not exactly at 25 degrees, it is approximate. Therefore, the value is not exact. If the temperature were at 25 degrees, it would give 10K. Since the temperature is approximate, the value is proportional to the ambient temperature at the time of the reading. In the table, you can see that if the temperature is at 20 degrees, it should give 12.09K. If it is at 15 degrees, it should give 14.69K. The values are around these with a variation of 1%, as seen at the beginning of the video. If you are measuring on your equipment and testing a sensor, you should compare the theoretical value with the ambient temperature. If the value is too far off, it indicates that the component is defective. That's basically it. I hope I helped. If you liked it, leave a like and subscribe to the channel. I look forward to seeing you in the next videos. See you soon.